everybody. Welcome back to Vikings Connected. It's our Hollywood edition. Mm-hmm. The very handsome, dapper Chris Hockey.
Thank you, buddy.
Looking good in that suit.
Thank you.
My name is Erin Newberg. What do we have coming up next?
Skol LOL, brought to you by the Minnesota Lottery, just happens to feature two guys from L.A., Anthony Barr and Eric Kendricks. Take a look at this.
I remember we had grad night, like all the seniors in like California, they all meet at Disneyland, and it's like a big like party like to celebrate the end of the year. My first thought was, man, this dude's a running back? Like what? That's what I was thinking. I was like,
yeah.
How?
So he had really nice hair, well kept.
Thank you.
Well, freshman year, everybody had stayed in the dorms, so like I was in Acacia, you were in Birch, I think.
Mm-hmm. Damn, good memory. So Dogwood.
One of our friends had moved out, so I moved in. It was you and our other friend, Ayo. And then across from us was our other three friends. We were in like a duplex almost, but it was two duplexes, so it was four units.
And it was all football players?
It was all football players. We had all the parties.
Brazers. Our house was like the VIP.
It was.
532.
Yeah, 532.
532.
That was the address, 532 Midvale.
And it was like, sometimes we wouldn't even like, sometimes it was like, a Friday or Thursday before a game, and we're all shutting it down, like just chilling.
People still.
And then
up.
It would be like people would be like 5-3-2, and it would be like our courtyard would just be full of people.
We'd be like, bro, we got practice in the morning. It's gonna be tough. I was at the draft party actually at the stadium. I was just like watching the draft as I was going there, like asking me questions about it, and then I was like, man, it'd be great if they picked Eric, and then they picked him. I was like, oh, like it was pretty crazy.
I thought I knew kind of like a range where I was gonna go. And then after a certain while, I was just like, it didn't even sink in yet. And I didn't even realize that he was on the Vikings either. Like, and then I was like, oh, that's crazy. Yeah. I called him pretty close. I called him like one of the first people to call him for sure. And it was just
There's
like-
no words. Ah, 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 ah,
ah, okay, ah, all right, bye.
I mean, it was cool, man. I remember them being super hard on him though. Like, no matter what he did, like, even if he was making plays, they were just like, oh, you gotta do this better, or you gotta be here, your alignment's like this, or I would see someone else make the same mistake, and Chad would do it, and they'd just be like, like, whatever, like, just, like, not even, like, acknowledge it.
I think it was probably because I did feel comfortable, because I did have a friend that was on the team, like.
Because I didn't say nothing to anybody, like, I didn't know anybody, you know what I'm saying? So, I was a new guy, rookie, and I didn't say a word, I was just gonna do my job, and that's it. And then he was a little different, he was more, like, outgoing and a little, like.
I came in a little too comfortable, probably, so they were just
yeah,
like,
so he was like, oh, it's gonna be sweet, isn't it?
Yeah, they were on me.
They was on him, tough.
I feel like if we generally have like the kind of like a similar, I'll just call it a palette. So like we have a similar palette, so we kind of like agree on the same stuff. But I feel like if we disagree on something, we'll definitely disagree.
Definitely disagree, but definitely gang up on somebody if they're deserving of it. We're gonna come after you.
And sometimes people start noticing that too, and they don't like it. Like Everson, he doesn't like it. Well, sometimes I don't even know what Anthony's like saying to Everson.
Exactly.
I just jump in like and just start like just because I just want him, you know.
No, it's usually like that. It could be anything, honestly. And we'll just disagree just to upset him. Even though if he's right, we'll just try to convince him that he's wrong. And then he'll jump in, and then he'll get even more upset, which is great. This is exactly what we want. And it works every time. he always falls for it.
When I got out here, it was cool. Like, everybody, you know, everyone thought, I mean, I thought I was kind of going to be like, nothing out here kind of thing, because I'm from California. I only had hoodies. Like the warmest thing I had was a hoodie. And I remember like trying to stretch that out for the longest time. Like, and then one day I was just like, I woke up and I was like, I gotta get a jacket today.
Like it was the pre-draft process and they're like a top 30 visit or whatever, you know? So you come out here, it was April and I was coming from California. So I was in my Vans and my sweat shorts and like a little crew neck. And I got here and it was snowing, like a snowstorm, like April, like end of April. And I'm like, bro, this place is crazy, this is terrible. Like, please don't draft me. Like, I do not want to be out here in April in the snow. And then 2 weeks later, Minnesota 952 get a call during the draft. I'm like, oh, it's Rick. And he's like, oh, well, you want to be a Viking? I'm like, hell yeah, can't wait. But it's been good. Like, I actually prefer the cold over. I'd rather be 40 than 90.
I never had a true fall either. Like, I thought I kind of knew what fall was, but like, I never had a true fall until I got here, which you could respect and love as well. Okay, we got two lanes most of the way. Like, everywhere here is like mostly two lanes, unless you're going like downtown or something. So like, if you're going slower, you should get in the right lane. If someone comes behind me and they're going faster than me, I'm gonna get over, let them pass me. I feel like that's normal, like.
They don't like to let you over for whatever reason. They try to speed up and block you from getting over.
If I put my blinker on, all of a sudden the car next to me is like racing me. And don't pull up like next to me like this and like, we're not gonna just drive down the street together. Like, that's not safe.
The on-ramps and the off-ramps are so terrible here. Like, it merges into one so fast and it causes so much traffic.
Oh yeah, when you're trying to like,
if you're trying to exit to another freeway and another one's merging here and it's all in one lane, like who designed it? It's a terrible design. What else is terrible? Like they have the audacity to shut down major freeways during a Saturday. You can't do that. Oh, the thing I hate the most is no turn on red. Like why the not? Nobody's coming and I can't turn on red. I'm just sitting here forever. And then people actually obey that. So then I'll go up in the straight lane and I'll turn right illegally because I'm not gonna wait an extra 2 minutes. There's no reason. Nobody's coming. There's little things like that really piss me off. Yeah, come to California, you learn how to drive right.
When I was there for the bye week, like I'm on the freeway and I'm going like, the speed limit is like 65 probably. I'm on the freeway going 65 and cars are flying by me.
Honking at you.
If there's no traffic, people are going 85.
Easy.
Like, it's like, oh my, like people drive so fast here.
It's an adjustment. It's crazy. Yeah, when I get back, I'm just like, oh, I gotta slow down.